Today for Mousetrap Monday, get ready to catch a bucket full of mice with a brand new mousetrap invented by a YouTube viewer named Dave. Thank you so much to Dave for sending me your latest creation. This is great. Consists of a plastic dome that fits on a 5-gallon bucket. Mouse can't enter except through a hole right here. It goes up through a ramp, and inside is a walkway. This is solid. It doesn't move at all. But on the walkway are 4 metal plates. Dave made the components of this trap by rewiring an electronic fly swatter. Takes 2 AA batteries. With the batteries in, we can turn on the trap. Flip down the switch. In the middle is a red light. That way you know it's hot. Mouse will go up the ramp, smell the peanut butter, go out there, zzz, get shocked and jump in the side. Now I'm gonna see what happens when we touch the metal pads with steel wool. Ooh. Okay, with lightning inside, we're gonna call this trap the Thunderdome. Turn it off. This is a trap you don't wanna mess with. I'm gonna add some peanut butter for bait. Let's go attach our trap to the bucket. First, we'll bolt down the ramp. Then we'll secure the dome to the bucket. Now I want to see if my pet mice feel secure on the trap, but I'm not going to turn it on. There's a huge difference between pest control and animal abuse. Taking captive animals and shocking them, that's just torture. Now the Thunderdome is a non-lethal trap. It's my wife, it's her birthday. Hey babe. Now the Thunderdome's a non-lethal trap. The shock's not powerful enough to kill the mouse. It's simply designed to make the mouse jump to the side and down in the bucket. I'm really curious how strong it is. It made quite a spark with the steel wool. But because I'm not testing it out with my pet mice, there's only one way to find out. Test it out myself. It's only 2 AA batteries. How strong can it be? We'll flip it on. The red light's on. Okay, that's more than a simple tickle. I compare it to an electric fence. I wouldn't recommend trying it yourself. We'll turn this off. It's amazing how much power it has for 2 AA batteries. The mice will simply drop down in the bucket. They won't be harmed. Now, before I show you this trap in action, I want to be very clear about something. Oh, hi, Clementine, come here. My daughter's visiting me. What's this? Is this a mouse trap?
Yeah.
The mice will simply drop down in the bucket. They'll be completely fine. Now, before I show you this trap in action, I want to be very clear about something. I'm not going to show the exact moment the mouse touches the pads and gets shocked. And that's for a very specific reason. I'll completely explain it at the end of the video. But for now, if you want to see the full sequence of this trap in action, I'll make that footage available on my website. But I'm going to reattach it to the bucket and go set it up in the barn with motion cameras. Then we'll test it out and see how well it works on... What's up there?
A light.
A light. We have lighting up here and a microphone.
Yeah.
So I'm going to reattach the trap to the bucket.
And we got a new trap.
We bought a new truck recently, a new Tundra.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna reattach the trap to the bucket and we're gonna go set it up in the barn with motion cameras to see how well it works on wild mice. Say the Thunderdome mousetrap.
The Thunderdome mousetrap.
Good job. Let's go set it up and see how well it works. All right, say bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Sorry for the interruption. I film whenever I can. Last night we set up the Thunderdome mousetrap in the barn and we caught 4 mice. 3 of them went up the ramp, touched the metal pads, got shocked, and jumped down in the bucket. And one of them just jumped in the bucket for no reason. That shows how effective this plastic dome is. This worked with the electric trap, but a dome like this on a bucket would also work with a walk the plank or rolling log. They could only enter one way and they can't jump out to the side. Now I'm gonna take these 4 mice. They're not native deer mice, they're house mice. So I'm gonna keep them as pets. We'll put them in a cage with food and water and take good care of them. They seem just fine, they're not hurt at all. But overall, a very clever way to catch mice. An electric pad on a bucket. They'll go up the ramp, drop down. If you wanna make it a kill trap, you just add water. Be careful though with the electronics, you don't want the backsplash. I am so encouraged by the huge number of viewers that watch my videos and leave comments. This is a great community. But every day on my YouTube videos, I receive comments from viewers who are disappointed or even downright nasty towards me for the way I edit my videos. They say they're gonna unsubscribe and never watch again, and that's because I'm not showing them what they wanna see, which is the traps in action. Recently, I've had to become so selective in what I show. I make that footage available on my website, but I can't show it on my YouTube channel. If I showed that, I'd receive content strikes and the Mousetrap Monday channel would disappear from YouTube. Well, this is kind of funny. It's actually a few days later and I filmed a completely different ending for this video. I went through all the edits and was just about ready to upload it to YouTube. But after reviewing it, I feel like I got really worked up and went on a rant. YouTubers have to deal with so much and oftentimes you see them going on tangents. Well, I decided to keep things positive for this video, so I'm not gonna include that footage. If you wanna see what got me so worked up, I'll put the extra footage on my website. But for now, things are actually going really well on YouTube. Things are getting much better. One thing that changed is I started posting fewer videos, but they're longer, and I'm putting a lot more effort into them. So it's going for quality over quantity. That seems to really help. So for now, I might drop down. I was doing 4 videos a week, then I dropped down to 2, and I might go to 1 just on Mondays. So Mousetrap Monday, for the first time in history, might only show videos on Monday, but they're gonna be longer, higher quality videos. Seems to work with the YouTube algorithm. Things are getting much, much, much better. At one point, it was getting pretty bad. I was down about 80 to 90% of what I was getting before. And every video I upload right now is instantly demonetized. So doing just 1 video a week will give me time to have it reviewed before it goes live. But thank you so much for all the support. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please consider clicking the button right here. I've posted over 550 videos on YouTube, and currently I'm gonna post new videos every Monday. So if you wanna see how to catch mice, rats, squirrels, chipmunks, moles, voles, and gophers, stay tuned.